When we talk about economic growth models, we need to recognize why it's important for us to learn about long-run economic growth. We're trying to explain why some countries grow and others don't. We're also interested in learning how generational living standards might vary within a country. Most importantly, we're trying to come up with solutions to help design policy to help economies grow. From a policy standpoint, the question we ask is, what can governments do to help increase the productivity and the living standards of its citizens? When we introduce economic growth, we discuss how economic growth evolves through the three different channels. The first way is through increasing resources. Resources are defined as natural resources, human resources, or physical resources. The second way to facilitate economic growth is through the introduction of technology. The third and final way is through institutions. We talked about what we mean by institutions and how they help create an environment where individuals can make long-term decisions, which is important for innovation and growth. The thing to think about is the evolution of economic growth theory is that we really didn't come to the realization directly. Economists first started with a real-world observation. They looked at the world and noticed something that required an explanation. Using this data that they saw in the real world, they helped develop a theory to explain the observation. They applied it to real-world scenarios. The theory then influenced policy. Governments implemented this policy. The process does not stop there, though. Economists look at how the policy changed the real-world observations. And this creates a cycle where we're always refining our theories and our policies based on real-world observations. So when we talk about economic growth models, it is through this observation that the models were defined. As the world changes, our theories will have to change to reflect the new reality. You too can be part of that process. Look at the world around you and see what can and cannot be explained. Where economic theory might need to be adjusted, looking at data allows us to examine real-world observations of human behavior and economic outcomes. Each economist has their own area of human and economic behavior that they are trying to figure out. I have two areas of interest. The first is focused on household decisions around personal finance. I'm interested in differences in wealth accumulation and what might explain how people save, spend, and accumulate wealth. The second area is economic education and how to best increase awareness of economics and decision making. What connects the two areas of my interest is the role of information in decision making. If people are better informed, will they make better decisions? Why are people informed at different rates? Is there a basic level of understanding that must exist to help people make better financial decisions? Economic models are important to explain the world, to help us prescribe policies and solutions, hopefully making the world a better place. This is what economists work on. The work is never complete because people change. The world changes, and new models and theories are needed to help design better policy. In the next videos, we will talk about the evolution of economic theory, what worked, what didn't work, and how the theories were adjusted.